The main thing that's new about genetic modification is that we can now take genes from one organism and introduce them into another organism, something that would not happen in the course of nature. And the process by which this is done, there's potential to cause all sorts of collateral damage in the genome of organisms. And it's very hard to foresee all of the downstream consequences of making those changes. For example, you can take flounders have an antifreeze protein that enables them to swim in very cold water and not freeze solid. So you can take the gene that makes that protein and put it into strawberries. And at first glance, this sounds like maybe this is a good thing. It would enable you to grow strawberries at higher latitudes, longer in the year, that they'd resist freezing. There'd be more strawberries for everybody. That could be good. On the other hand, who knows what might happen if human beings start eating this flounder protein in greater quantity than they ever did. I mean, it might cause allergies, it might do other things, we don't know. And it just seems to me that, you know, if the people doing this are, you know, first of all, trying to foresee all this stuff, that would be okay, but I doubt that they are. And if they're doing these things to produce fruits and vegetables of higher quality with better nutritional profiles, that's one thing, but that's not what they're doing. They're doing it to either make things that are more resistant to shipping, so forth. And there is a body of scientific evidence showing that animals that are fed genetically modified crops develop ranges of health problems. So it's an area in which I would be cautious, and at least we shouldn't have these things foisted on us without our knowledge. So at least there should be clear labeling that products are genetically modified, so we have the, you know, can choose whether we want to buy them or not. There are actually already a lot of things out there that we're eating that we can't do anything about. But this is, I think, one of the good things about the federal organic standards is that, you know, if something carries that label from the Department of Agriculture, it can't be genetically modified.